Welcome back, guys. Welcome back to Record Entertainment. I know I did a top 5 movies of all time list once, but this is going to be my top 10 movies of all time. And don't worry, the original one's not on the list anymore. So, I just wanted to give you, like, kind of where I am right now. What's the top 10 to me? So, let's get straight into it. Shrek was a movie that I didn't catch up with for a long time. And honestly, I really like Shrek. I think it's a lot better than the fourth movie, certainly. And I think just the world they came up with here is amazing, and what they were able to do. This is such a funny movie. The voice cast is absolutely amazing. The story is stellar. The animation looks great for 2001. Overall, I think Shrek is just an overall classic, and that's something that you can't deny. My number 9 spot goes to Lego Movie. I really like the Lego Movie. It was such a risk, but it paid off so well. And again, like Shrek, just developed this world that I've never seen anything like it before. And yes, the Emoji Movie did try to copy this with this opening. This is such a great movie. Emma is such a likable main character, and it's just such a fun journey. These are probably the movies I like the most. I don't know if they're the necessarily best, but what can I say? I just really, really enjoy this movie and really like it. And I just love the story here once again. And then bringing all these characters in this crossover world, it's just such a fun concept, and it works so, so well. The 8th film that comes to mind when I think of best of all time is Toy Story. Okay, maybe I'm just a sucker for great world building. You can quote me on that, but this is just such an amazing film. It has such a simple premise, but works so well. I mean, like, other films have been bigger and more ambitious, but something that you can do is, by going small, also make a great film. I just love this adventure. It's so much fun. All of the characters really work for me. Toy Story is just a great movie, and it's just always such a pleasure to watch every single time. I haven't seen it that many times, but it's such an incredible film. Also, let me know your thoughts on the upcoming Lightyear. I absolutely love this film, and I really, really love it. I'm so glad I watched the real version, because if I didn't, this would not be on this list. Thankfully, I have, and it's on this list. I doubt many people know about my number 7, but my number 7 is The Cross and the Switchblade. Now, this is a film that I found on YouTube, but I'm so glad I watched this film, because it's such a great demonstration of redemption, a theme that I love so much, and I firmly believe is possible for anyone. I mean, it just tackles this theme so well, and it has to get in my top 10 films of all time, because it does its job so well. Yes, this is based on a true story. It's such an uncomfortable film to watch when we just go into bars and just see all these people with destroyed lives, but redemption is possible for anyone, and it's just such a beautiful thing to just feel, and I absolutely love that this film does that. I could put this film higher, but maybe I'll put it here, because it's not particularly easy to watch. But man, if you haven't seen this film, go check it out. Really, go check it out, because it is such an incredible film. My number 6 spot goes to Big Hero 6. Big Hero 6 is definitely a more charming movie than the past one. I mean, this film is so watchable. It's just so much fun to go into this kind of zany world of, well, superheroes. It's not exactly a superhero world building, but just I love this film. I love just how much fun you can have with it. The emotion they demonstrate here is great. Baymax, one of my most favorite comic reliefs of all time. Like, it's hard not to love this film. It's such an easy one to put on. And just, Hero is a great main character. The final battle one of the best I've ever seen. Big Hero 6, it just deserves this place on the list. And that's why it has this place on the list. Number 5 is Star Wars Episode 3, Revenge of the Sith. I absolutely love this film. I mean, that final battle. Anakin, I left you like my brother. I have the high ground, master. I mean, this film. It's just an amazing film. The place we see Anakin go to, his continuation from The Phantom Menace and Attack of the Clones, just all of this film is just amazing and a great example of what a Star Wars movie should be. This is just such an incredible film. I'm glad I continue with the saga so I got to see this film. What an amazing masterpiece. Like, oh boy, just this film. This film is incredible, and the story of Darth Vader, it's so amazing, and Revenge of the Sith is a great film. Then there's The Incredibles. Yes, I am kind of biased. I do really, really like superheroes. Why? Because I'm at that age. I'm literally 14. But, come on. It's an amazing film. I mean, Syndrome, great villain. Bob, great main character. The animation is absolutely stunning. The story is amazing. The structure is really good. And I just love what they can do with this film. What Brad Bird did with this film, making it the first PG-rated Pixar film. Like try his best at kind of MCU film. And I think it worked really well. It could have been a big flunk, but it wasn't. And I'm glad that he took this risk, because Brad Bird is the master of taking risks. This is just such an incredible film. They do everything so well. The dialogue here is some of the best I've ever seen in a film. And it's a great way to tell a story that feels real and it's about superheroes at the same time. What can I say? It's incredible. And number 3. I know the Lego Ninjago movie doesn't have the greatest of reputations, and I know a lot of people really hate this film and say it destroyed the show. Listen, I was 4 when the show came out. I didn't even know it existed. So when I just saw the Lego Ninjago movie, I don't know. I was just more of a Lego Ninjago movie fan, which I know nobody is. But it's just a world that I love to go to. There are characters I love to see. I believe I saw this film around December of the year it came out. And then I watched it maybe one good trillion times. Out of all the films ever, this is definitely the one I've watched the most. I can say that without a shadow of a doubt. It is truly an incredible film. I love what they did here. And I guess I just really love Lego movies. But Lloyd, he's just such a great guy who you really get to care about. What they did with this film, I really loved. And I still love it to this day, even after all the crap it's got for 4 years. Okay. I know I did a debate on this film, and I was on the negative side. But listen, I came around to Spider Verse. And look where it is now. It's at number 2 on my top 10 favorite movies of all time. There's obviously that influence. Spider Verse is just such an amazing film. I mean, it's actually the last one of the world building is amazing. And it's just such a pleasure to go into this world. It's such a great film that works so well. Of course, you people already knew what number one was. You know me. It's Return of the Jedi. It's such an incredible film. Darth Vader is actually really a really likable character here. He doesn't feel like this guy who just tortured people. He feels like this guy with emotions who cares about his son. And obviously, I think the prequels helped that out a whole lot. And just, this is such a great finale to the trilogy. Maybe should have been the finale to Star Wars. And just what they could do here with Luke, Yoda, everything. Yoda's death was actually pretty sad. And I mean, I just love this film. That final battle, again, my favorite final battle of all time. It's such a great film. It ended the trilogy so well. And this is just a joyride. This is a joyride film. Unlike the other two Star Wars finales, this one is just such a joyride, and I love it, and I could watch it forever. Well, that's my list, and I'd love to see yours down in the comments. What are your top 10 films of all time? I'd love to see them. Make sure to respect others' and mine's opinions, and let's have a great day.